Hi guys, I'm Quipster, and today this tutorial is going to be a little bit different because it's for one man and one man alone. And his name sounds made up. Raffaele Legatola. Sounds like some sort of Italian superhero or someone who's going to break your heart. More on that later. But no, he's a dear friend of mine. We were actually on the fencing team together at uni. Yes, I know, I'm painfully middle class. Raff used to be in the hobby years and years ago, and over the last year and a half, I've basically been bullying him to get back into it. And it's worked. About 2 weeks ago, he got an Indominus box, and he decided, okay, I'm going to collect Black Templars. And I was like, Raff, I got you. I'm gonna give you a tutorial of everything you need to do, everything you need to buy for your first miniatures. And this is that tutorial. So before you paint your miniatures, you're going to need to prep and to build them. And that is a process in itself. And for that, you're going to need a couple of things. So the first thing you're going to do is you're just going to clip everything out of the sprue. Now you're going to be left with all of these bits. And the question is, what are you going to do with them all? Now I use these plastic shot glasses. They're super cheap, super inexpensive. I get them in bulk from Amazon. Now you're gonna use the mold line remover tool to just clean up all the little mold lines there. If there are any that you can't get to in any of the nooks and crannies, just use the hobby knife. Just remember when you're doing it to mind your fingers. One of the things that I'm quite panicky about is drilling your gun barrels. That's what the little pin vise drill is for. For one, it means you don't have to paint the little black holes there. And number two, I think it just looks better. Just remember when you drill the holes, take it slow, it's not a race. And when you drill into the front of the barrel, remember to do a little guide hole with a sharp knife or a pin or something. It doesn't have to be big, just a little thing so that your drill doesn't just shoot off in a weird direction. While we're here, I also drill into the backpack and the underside of the neck, and I mount those on corks. This is a completely superfluous step, totally unnecessary, but I'm a bit of a perfectionist. This is totally optional. You can just stick the model together, that's totally fine. Now, the other reason I've got the pin vise drill is because I'm gonna drill a little hole in his foot. The reason for that is because we're gonna mount it again on the little cork. Normally it would be the case that I would just glue it to the plastic base and just have the base on a GW painting handle. But these particular models for Raff are going to be on resin bases. These are the ones that Raff picked and I think they look phenomenal. If it had been the case that we weren't putting them on resin bases and we're putting them on plastic bases, we can just skip this step and you don't need to mount them on corks. So now that you've got everything put together, it's either on corks or on painting handles, you need to undercoat it. Some people like to paint onto the bare plastic without an undercoat, and I would say don't do that personally, and the reason for that is because the undercoat on the miniature provides a really nice surface for the paint to stick in a way that plastic, resin, and metal kind of don't. So it just helps the paint adhere properly to the miniature itself so that it's less likely to chip off, basically. Now, when you're choosing a color that you're going to prime something with, you have to remember that number one, the colored sprays that Games Workshop makes aren't actually undercoats, they're just spray paint. What you're supposed to do is undercoat a miniature first with one of the specifically labeled undercoat paints. So Chaos Black, Wraithbone, Gracier, those kinds of ones. So for example, if you're gonna paint custodies and they were gonna be gold, I would do the black undercoat and then the Retributor armor spray on top. Now for Raff's Black Templars, we're gonna use the black undercoat. On top of that, we're gonna paint a different black. Just remember, when you're spraying something, always keep the can and the miniature in motion. That way you don't overspray any one particular part of the model. And if that happens, it's so soul destroying because you have to strip it. You end up with gunk all over usually the face and you can't see any of the details and it's a massive pain in the ass.
Do you still love me, brother? Be strong, Clarence. Be strong for the Emperor.
The other thing to remember when you're undercoating a model or using any kind of spray paint, always remember to wear a mask.
Gotham will be ashes, Batman.
You don't want to be breathing any of those fumes. Also, don't worry, if you screw up the priming stage, I'll make a video about how to strip models. Quick spoiler, this is the secret. So So now we move on to the color scheme. Picking a color scheme, it feels like a really big deal, kind of because it is. And the reason for that is because you're gonna be painting a lot of whatever these colors are for like quite a while. So that can feel quite daunting. When you're picking a color scheme, there are a couple of ways of doing it. Either you can choose an army whose lore you really enjoy. For example, if you really enjoy the Ultramarines and Rebute Gilliman, it looks like you're gonna be painting a lot of blue. Or if you enjoy Dawn, Rogal Dawn and the Imperial Fist, well, it looks like you're gonna be painting a lot of yellow. And there are lots of tutorials out there about how to paint those specific schemes, especially from Games Workshop. Now, Raff has chosen Black Templars. Basically, when you choose a color scheme for a model for the classic method, which is what we're gonna show today, there are three different stages: the base, the wash, and the highlight. And the reason for that is because if you just spray something, it will be a very flat, very uninteresting looking model, no matter if you paint all the details or not. The wash goes in all the recesses of the model, all the little gaps and stuff, and the highlights go on all the edges. It's pretty much as simple as that. Now, obviously with Black Templars, they're already black, so you can't really put anything in the shadows or the recesses because can't go darker than black.
Yeah, I know it's sexy, Woodhouse. That's why I bought 10. I'll arrange those by color.
These are all black.
Oh, are they? Or are 5 in a dark black and 5 in a slightly darker black?
Which is why on Black Templars, you just have to really work at the highlights. And this is one of the reasons that people say black is such a hard color to paint. Not necessarily. And one of the things to remember when you're painting, especially your first models, is that you're going to make mistakes.
It was at this moment Jackson knew. He fucked up.
And that's totally fine. That's one of the reasons that we're about to use Abaddon Black over the Chaos Black. You might be thinking, it's already got a black undercoat. Why does it need more black on top?
Slightly darker black.
Because the finish of the undercoat is slightly different to the Abaddon Black. So if you make any mistakes and you have to touch it up with Abaddon Black, it will look weird. You will see the patches of a different type of black. So we just give every model just a quick once over with the Abaddon Black. So while I'm base coating these things, sorry Raff, I'm gonna tell this story. So it might have struck you as odd that I would be going to all of this effort to make the video and paint all this stuff just to help a friend get it back into the hobby. And you would be correct, because the reason I'm doing this is mainly out of a sense of guilt, because I may have done the second meanest thing I've ever done in my life to Raff. And basically, what this was, we were on the fencing team together at uni, and while we were at a competition, I thought I'd play a bit of a prank on Raph, because, you know, he is just the nicest guy ever, and he's such a dear friend. So I went up to a couple of the fencing girls, and I was just like, hey, girls, I don't know if you know this, but Raph's a bit of a player. He's a bit of a ladies' man. You've got to watch yourselves around him. And they were just like, wow, really? Oh, God, well, I suppose, you know, he's a handsome guy. I guess it is the quiet ones. Yes. It is the quiet ones. And I thought nothing of it. 2 years later, I was at practice and it was the beginning of a new year. I overheard a conversation between one of the senior guys in the team and a couple of the fresher girls. And he said, girls, I don't know if you know this, but Raph's a bit of a player. He's a bit of a ladies' man. You've got to watch yourselves around him. No way has that just happened. And so I didn't tell Raph until 5 years later, to which he responded, you bastard. It all makes so much sense now. So, yeah. Sorry, Raph. This is my apology video. Here's how to paint Space Marines. So the first thing you're gonna paint on the model are all of the metal silver bits. So this includes the undersuit, gun parts, chainsword, and some parts on the backpack as well. One thing you've gotta remember when you're painting, remember to thin down your paint. What I like to do is take the brush and wipe off the excess on my thumb or the palette, just so there's only as much as I need on the brush and it doesn't splodge everywhere. The next part we're gonna paint is the chest eagle. Ignore my fat head in the foreground. This is gonna take you 2 thin coats with Wraithbone. The other parts to paint with Wraithbone are all the purity seals on the model as well. Now we paint all the red parts on the model. So this is again gonna be 2 thin coats with Horn Red. So you're painting the gun parts, the chainsword, and the edges of the shoulder armor. Now you're gonna move on to Doomball Brown, and that's gonna be for all the pouches and his gun holster. Next, we're going to paint all the gold parts. So on his arm, there's a sort of crucifix pattern, which is the Indomitus logo. We're going to paint that gold. And also, his sergeant's helmet has a skull on the front of it that we're going to paint gold as well. Now we're going to get skeleton horde contrast paint, and we're going to put this all over the chest eagle. Now what this is going to do is fill into the recesses and give a really nice depth. So don't be afraid to just kind of splodge this on. And if there's too much, you can wick it away using the brush. You're going to go and put this on the purity seals as well and do the exact same thing. Next, we're going to shade all of the red parts with Agrax Earthshade. Don't worry about getting this on any of the black at the moment, because we're going to be touching up a bit later anyway. And now we're going to shade all of the metal parts and all the brown parts with Nuln Oil. Again, don't be afraid about getting this kind of everywhere. We're going to touch up a bit later. Now it's time to edge highlight all of the brown parts with Scrag Brown. Yeah, it's basically poo brown. That's basically what it is. Just remember to draw a thin line across all of the edges on all of the different pouches, and that's all you need to do. Now quickly, while we're here, this sergeant has a unique weapon called a plasma pistol. And the little coils here, we're gonna do something a little bit different with. We're gonna paint the plasma coils here with Wraithbone, and then, after giving that two quick coats, we're gonna just put some Talisar Blue over the top of that, just to give that kind of glowing effect. It's really quick, really simple, but it looks fantastic. We're going to quickly paint the purity seals now. This is super easy, and if you don't want to do this step, you can just paint them corn red with a quick wash, and that's totally fine. What we're going to do is paint the Screamer Pink over the wax seal instead, and we're going to wash that with Caraberg Crimson, and then highlight that with Pink Horror. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put a dot in the middle and then just a few selective edge highlights around the edges, and that's really gonna bring it out. Now what we're gonna do here is something called dry brushing, and that's where we take literally a dry brush and put some paint on it and then dab off most of the paint on the brush. I'm doing it here on my hand because it allows me to really control how much is on the brush. Then we're gonna dry brush the chest eagle to really bring out the highlights of it there. Again, don't worry about this being a little bit messy. We're gonna touch this up in a little bit. So in this tutorial, I've been showing you how to paint a Black Templars sergeant. Now, the sergeants are actually a little bit different to the whole rest of the army because the shoulder pads are black, not white. So this is how to paint the rest of the army. So I'm going to show you how this color scheme is going to work on this black shoulder pad. Now, normally the shoulder pads would be attached to the model, but in this case, this model has black shoulder pads. So first, what you're going to do is you're going to paint a thin layer of gray sear over the top of the black. Then over the top of that, you're going to put three thin layers of Orthuan Grey. Then after you finish the Orthuan Grey, you wanna get out the corn red and start painting around the edges of the armor panel. You wanna be really careful here. I'm using the edge of the brush. As you can see here, there's a little inside bit to the edge of the armor rim. I've chosen to paint that, and I'm being very, very careful. You can paint this if you want, but it's not really necessary. Now we move on to washing the corn red with a little bit of Agrax Earthshade. Now, don't worry if a little bit of this goes onto the edge of the white. Now, the last thing we're gonna do is do a quick edge highlight around the edge of the red with Evil Sun Scarlet. Talking about Evil Sun Scarlet, now we're gonna edge highlight around all of the red parts that have been washed with the Agrax with Evil Sun Scarlet now. This includes the edges of the shoulders, the weapon casings, and the chainsword. Now we're gonna clean up the entire model by getting Abaddon Black and tidying up all the places where you've got paint overspill onto the black parts of the model. The chest eagle, maybe around the legs, and also around the shoulders. Now we're gonna move on to painting the eyes. And I paint the eye lenses the same way that I paint gems. It's a really simple process. All you do is you start with the black, then you do a big C of a dark red inside that, and then inside that big C, you do a smaller C of a lighter red, and then inside that, you do a little line of orange, and then on the other side, you do a small dot of white. And that's basically it. And I use the same thing for any gems that I paint. So you don't have to do this step, but I think it's worth it. We're gonna get a very fine brush and some fairly watered down Abaddon Black, and we're gonna paint the writing on the purity seals. And it's literally just doing very careful, squiggly little lines. So now you're gonna paint the edge highlights around the black parts of the armor. For that, we're gonna use Eschen Gray. Now what you're gonna do here, because this is just a tabletop standard, you don't actually need to edge highlight every single edge on the armor. All you need to do is edge highlight the bits of the armor that your eye is drawn to. So that's the legs, the chest, the head, and to a degree the shoulders. Now the shoulders you've already done because of the red, but the rest of the armor, the chest, a bit of the torso, and the front of the legs, that we're gonna do right now. Now on top of the Eschen Grey highlight, on the very sharpest edges, we're gonna add a little bit of something just to bring out the highlight. We're gonna use Dawnstone on very, very selective highlight just to make the model pop. Now the last thing we're gonna do is we're gonna paint dark flesh on the bare head of the model. Now I know what a lot of you are gonna be out there thinking, like, why are you only showing us how to do dark flesh? I can tell you why, because painting light flesh is super easy. All you have to do is paint the model Wraithbone and then put Gilliman flesh on top and you're done. Literally, that's it. It doesn't need anything else for a tabletop standard anyway. I swear, Gilliman flesh is just magic. Now for dark flesh, what I do is I follow the Darren Latham tutorial that he posted on his Instagram just quite badly.
You start with Rhinox hide under the black undercoat.
Next, you put Nuln Oil all over the face.
Then a 50-50 mix of Rhinox Hide and Mournfang Brown, and that you apply to all of the like lighter bits of the model. So maybe a bit of the jaw, the cheeks, the nose, bits of the brow, the bits that light is going to hit. And you wanna leave the recesses dark with the Nuln Oil. Then I move to a highlight on top of that of just Mournfang Brown. And then on top of that, I add a 50-50 mix, just at the very sharpest points. So on the nose, just there, and on the nostrils, this bit here, and a little bit on the cheeks, just there. As a 50-50 mix of Scrag Brown and Mournfang Brown. Now Darren Latham, when he does his tutorial, takes it all the way up to Ubshanti Bone, and I'm not brave enough for that, and this will do for a simple tabletop standard. After that, we're just gonna quickly paint the eyes, and just take your time. I know it can be a bit intimidating painting eyes, but all I've done is I've painted all Thuan Grey, because you don't wanna go too bright with the white that you use. I've done a bit of a mistake, so I'm gonna go back with the Rhinox Hide to just touch up that, and then a little dot of Abaddon Black just in the center for the pupil. And that's it, just take your time. And if you need to touch up, then just do a little touch up. I'm also gonna use the Thuan Grey to paint his teeth, and then inside that, his tongue, I'm just going to use two thin coats of Screamer Pink. And that's it. For his hair, all I did was I touched up with Abaddon Black, then a quick dry brush of Eschen Grey, and then a quick dry brush on top of that of Dawnstone, just to bring it out.
Now we're gonna move on and we're gonna paint the base of the model. And one thing that people really underestimate is the importance of a good base, because what it can really do is bring out the model. Now Raff has chosen these resin bases. We've undercoated them black. And the first thing we're gonna do is paint the sort of dirt around the outside of the marble tiles, dryad bark. We're gonna give that two very thin down layers. And the layers are gonna be very thin so that we can get all of those recesses. This is the point at which you wanna have like a bit of a throw away brush that you don't mind hacking a little bit, because this process of basing is not kind on brushes. Next thing you want to do is just give it a quick wash with Agrax Earthshade, and then after that give it a dry brush like we talked about earlier with Bane Blade Brown. Now when you dry brush, literally remember to use a brush that is dry, otherwise you won't get the correct effect. Now you want to move on, and over the marble part you want to paint Grey Sear. Now, painting over black is always very difficult, but the Grey Sear is a great paint. You'll probably need two, at most three thin coats, but remember, thin coats are the way to go. You don't necessarily need to slap it on very thickly, otherwise you'll lose some of the details. Then once that's dry, you want to put on... Now this one, don't be afraid of just slapping it on. Make sure you're getting it all in the recesses. If you find any pooling, you can wick that away with a brush very easily. Now the last stage of this process to give the stone a little bit more texture is called stippling. Now it's a little bit like dry brushing, only the brush is wet and you're using kind of the end of it. I have a very special brush I use for this where I've cut the top bristles off. You don't have to do that. Another brush I think is really good for this is the GW Big Wash brush. What you do is you get a little bit of paint and you dab a little bit off, and then you just do this. onto the parts of the model that you're painting. And that will provide a really good texture. So first you're gonna do the stippling technique with Eschen Gray. Now over that, you're going to do Administratum Gray. And then finally, to really bring it out, you're going to use Ulthuan Gray as the final bit of stippling. And here you can see that it really starts to bring out that stone. So yeah, while we're here, I'm gonna quickly explain what pinning is. Pinning is literally where you just drill a hole in one side of something and drill a hole in the other side of something that you're trying to stick together, and you put a bit of material, so probably like a bit of paperclip between the two. The reason why you would do that is, say you've got a hand you need to attach to a forearm, that's a very small joint. That's very likely to break off. So you would do a pin. And you would pin it there, and it gives a lot more surface area for the super glue to hold something together. And it's a really good way of sticking stuff to resin bases, because otherwise they're quite likely to snap off. One of the final things we're gonna do is paint the nameplate on the model. I get these nameplates from versatileterrain.co.uk. The guy that runs the website is a guy called Keith, absolute legend. I highly recommend him. The link is down in the description. These nameplates can add a lot of personality to the base, and I wanted to surprise Raff with this one. So first, we're just gonna cut all the little support struts, make sure they're nice and smooth, and test fit that on the model just to make sure it all lines up nicely. Then we're gonna undercoat that with Chaos Black Spray and just follow the same process we did before with painting the red, painting the black, and painting the white. One of the finishing touches on the model is applying the decals. These can be the squad markings or the chapter logos. Now for Raff, these are the chapter logos and a little bit on his tilt shield. And the process for this is really simple. First, all of the areas that you're going to apply decals to, you paint with a single layer of gloss varnish. Then while that's drying, you want to cut out the decals that you're going to use and put them to one side. Once you've made sure that the gloss varnish is completely, completely dry, you're going to wet the decals. You're going to use some tweezers and a paintbrush that's clean to gently put the decal onto where you want it to be. Once the decal is on where you want it to be, I would apply a little bit of something called micro set. Now what this is going to do is set down and stick on that decal to where you want it to be. Now one thing you might notice is that the decal doesn't quite sit properly on certain curved surfaces. So what you're going to do is you're going to get a little bit of the micro sole and put that on the decal, and that will soften it and over time make it conform to that curved surface. So you're going to put a little bit on, wait for about 10 to 15 minutes, and then slowly start patting it down with the brush, just so it conforms. You might need to do that process a couple of times until it's completely flat. Then, once that is all completely dry, you do a single layer of the gloss varnish over all of the decals that are then finished and totally stuck down. So one of the last stages we're gonna do is the matte varnish. Now, I personally use Winsor & Newton professional matte varnish. And the reason I use this is because it provides a really good finish. It really makes the model pop in the end, and it will protect your model from bumps and scratches when you're playing on the table. Just bear in mind, it takes about half an hour to dry when you use it. Now the very last stage of the miniature is weathering. Now what we're gonna do here is I've gotten a soft pastel. You can buy these in art shops. I'll put the link in the description for where you can get this particular color. But literally all you do is you crush up one of these soft pastels. I've got a little Tupperware box that I did it in. And you just get a dry brush and brush on after you've varnished where you want this pigment to be. And what this will do is it will create sort of a layer of dust over the model and really add something, I think. Personally, I think it adds another layer of personality to the model rather than having it completely pristine. The last thing we're gonna do is called the victory lap. It's when you paint two thin layers around the edge of the base of Abaddon Black just to finish off and frame the model.
So yeah, that's the whole tutorial, and these are the finished product. That's it, the whole thing is finished. Now you might be thinking to yourself, hang on a sec, you look really different to how you did in the beginning of this tutorial. Yeah, the reason for that is because I took 7 months, I think, to make this video because I've got a lot going on, man. But yes, if you want a step-by-step guide of all the paints that you need to buy for this tutorial and the order in which to use them, there's a link down below for something called Trello. Click on that, download it, It will give you a step-by-step of how to do this particular tutorial. Underneath that is a link to my kit.co profile, which has all the recommendations of all the hobby products that I use. Also, it's got a whole bunch of Black Library recommendations that I have if you want to delve further into that side of the hobby. If you want to ask me any questions, the best place to get me is on Instagram or on Facebook, probably Instagram if you send me a DM. But yeah, that's kind of the whole tutorial. I don't know how to end this. Guess I'll just put some outtakes at the end then. After that, you want to use a 50-50 mix of Doomball Brown to... Shit, what's the other brown? So bear in mind, we were much younger and we were both very shy around women at the time. We're much older now.
Isn't this worse?
Isn't
this worse?
How is this worse?
Then anybody who knows Raff is going to see this, it's going to be like, oh, Raff, you're such a loser.
Not at all, it'd be fine.
You have to put that in as well. It's like, Raff, I'm sorry, I'm just telling a story.
Yeah, actually, I will put that. I will put it at the end. I may have done the second meanest thing I've ever done in my life to Raff.
What's the meanest thing?
Oh, what was it? I had a friend of mine who just started watching Game of Thrones, and you've seen it, right? Okay. So yeah, we were on season 4 and she just started, and she was just like, oh wow, you know, I'm loving what's happening so far, you know? And I was like, oh, who are your favorite characters? And she was just like, oh, I love, you know, the Starks, Sansa's kind of interesting. I love Jon Snow. Oh, and that's, what's his face? Ned Stark, he's really cool. And I was like, you know, he gets really good in season 2. Like, you gotta watch out for him. I got a text about 3 days later. All it said was, block capitals, I hate you. So yeah, and she's never forgiven me since. So yeah?
That's the meanest thing you've ever done.
I think so, yeah. She's never, it's been 12 years, she's never forgiven me.